call it La Llorona. In Argentina we call it La Llorona. I want to know which was the weirdest name that you heard of people telling this name of La Llorona.
My Sharona.
Yeah, I was going to say My Sharona.
My Sharona.
Mama, my Sharona.
And what about you? Was it hard to you to learn the...
No. I knew the double L. I understood. But, you know, for my character, though, she doesn't really know it. So for her to say it, there was no pressure for her to have to say it perfectly because she shouldn't really know how to pronounce it. She doesn't understand who she is. She doesn't know who she is.
She never heard of her.
Yeah. So it's, I was able to sort of let loose and have as poor as a, you know, poor diction as possible.
Like her character was very much like the audience will come and see it who've never heard of La Llorona.
Yeah.
Whereas we grew up with it, so we knew all about her, and we're shocked that Linda doesn't know anything about La Llorona.
What about the culture? Because the name is in Spanish also in the title, so I think that this movie has like a lot to say about Latin culture. Yeah. How does it make you feel?
Well, it makes us feel proud that we're part of a movie that's about our culture with an entity, a monster that very much belongs to us. And so we get to share that with the rest of the world because, again, like we grew up hearing about La Llorona from our relatives. It's handed down from generation to generation. And everyone in Latino culture knows about La Llorona. Mm-hmm. Like there's not anyone that doesn't know about it. So for other people not to know about her, it's like, it's amazing, right?
Yeah. Y al mismo tiempo es una gran responsabilidad. Yeah. Porque, you know, que se esté haciendo una película sobre La Llorona es como que nosotros dos estamos aquí asegurándonos de que se le trate con respeto. Y al mismo tiempo te sientes un poco como que te han escogido, como que ella nos escogió. Porque es muy real, ella es una entidad y hay que respetarla, pues.
You got to put her a face. How does it make you feel? How was working with Marisol for all of you?
Oh, wonderful.
Amazing. Great.
Was she hidden somewhere before you met her with the makeup?
She's beautiful.
And
so I remember when they cast her, I thought, well, she's beautiful. Gorgeous. How is she going to play? But the way that they did the makeup is so beautiful and terrifying.
This is so interesting because even though many days went by, así hayan pasado muchos días, ella igual no podías verla. Era como, no puedo comer contigo, Marisol.
There's like a Home Alone vibe in one scene in particular when you are expecting La Llorona and you are preparing the house with the kids. Is that on purpose or what do you think about this like connection? Maybe it's like so personal that...
Maybe it's Chavs. Maybe he wanted to make that connection.
Right. I think any film with children in jeopardy, you'll draw a similar conclusion to it, that, you know, it's this Home Alone thing. But it is, in the way the movie expresses it, that it's your child against this dark monster.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So, well, and what about the paranormal things? I know that your boundaries, like, broke in the middle of the set, but was there any other experience before this movie? How was your relationship with paranormal activity prior to this movie?
Well, Linda suffered a lot of paranormal activity on Scooby-Doo, right?
But it turns out it was just a masked man.
Oh. Yeah.
No, a mí sí me pasó algo. La noche anterior, haces un ejercicio de decirle a tu yo interior, lo escribes así, dices, querido yo interior, si es tu deseo, por favor, muéstrame en este sueño, en esta noche, en un sueño, ¿cómo se llama? El struggle, la lucha del personaje de Patricia para estar más cerca de ti. Entonces dices, con amor y respeto, lo firmas y le pones la fecha y la hora. Lo pones al lado de tu cama, te vas a dormir y siempre tienes un sueño. Y esa noche, en la noche antes de comenzar a filmar, me despertó un grito y que no, era como un lamento tan fuerte que salí corriendo al cuarto de mi hija, me caí, me golpeé, me empecé a sangrar. Después cuando mi hija estaba durmiendo, se despierta, la pongo a que se duerma, me voy a la cama y estoy en shock porque estoy sangrando y digo, ¿qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? Y de repente miro la hojita y dije, oh.
Rinsing.